Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel, and if you're new, then hello! One of the Emerald Tree Skinks wanted to join me for this intro, so he's here. I will be making more content on these guys soon. There's a lot of behind the scenes going on, I swear. But let's get the intro out of the way. Today, I'm actually filming in the reptile room because I've been busy doing a lot of different projects and upgrades over the past few months for a lot of my reptiles. Videos for those will start to slowly come out, and this is going to be one of them. In this video, we're going to be taking a look at my Malaysian cat gecko's new upgraded 24 by 18 by 18 bioactive vivarium with a custom DIY background that I made. I'll show you guys some of the work that I've been doing in here, give you a little tour of my Malaysian cat gecko's new crib, and just take a look at how Salem is doing in his new home. If you like this video, then be sure to give me a thumbs up, leave me a comment down below, and hit that subscribe button if you want to see updates on my pets and videos like this in the future. So I have done a lot of rearranging in the reptile room, as you guys know. So the 3-foot rack that I have that used to be on another wall is now here when you first walk in. And my Malaysian cat gecko's old enclosure is this one right here. So here we're gonna take a look at it from another angle. So Salem used to be in this 18 by 18 by 18 Exoterra, and he actually came with this enclosure. Just a recap for those who are new, my Malaysian cat gecko was a rehome from Kijiji, and the Bioactive Vivarium had come along with him as well. This enclosure is a nice size for a single male, but I want to give him just a bit more space, and also because in the future I did want to try housing him with a female. That won't be for a little while though, because if you guys remember a few videos ago, I did do a trade with Emma Samson, exchanging my two baby Emerald Tree Skinks for one of her baby cat geckos. Speaking of which, the baby Emerald Tree Skinks are actually right next to this tank. There's one of the babies right there. Hello. There's another. Hi. Oh my god, they're just so cute. Oh. Anyway, back to my cat gecko enclosure. So Emma plans on giving me a female Malaysian cat gecko, but she did mention that they are slow growing, so it would probably be a while before I'd be able to do a proper introduction between her and my male cat gecko. Some people will keep their Malaysian cat geckos separated and then will only introduce them during the breeding season, but some keepers keep pairs together without any issues, Emma being an example, especially if you have a large enough enclosure. So those are a few of the reasons why I want to update his enclosure. Another reason is that I actually had ordered this 24 by 18 by 18 for my Solomon Island leaf frogs, but I upgraded my Vietnamese Blue Beauties from their 36 by 18 by 18 Exoterra into a 4 foot by 2 foot by, I think it's like 18 high PVC. And I was wondering what I could do with the now spare 36 long tank. And then I felt it would be the perfect size for my Solomon Island leaf frogs. These frogs have such a big leap, so I wanted to get them the most space possible. And when I did see the 24 long in person, I was kind of like, it would be comfortable, but I feel that they could benefit from something even larger. It has just that extra foot to it that I just feel they need, especially because I did want to add one more frog in the future. My 3-inch frogs have like 3 feet of space to jump, and that makes me super happy. So my Blue Beauties are now in here, and my Solomon Island leaf frogs are now in there. And then you guys are probably wondering, where did my Colombian Rainbow Boa go? She's right next door here in this other PVC that has actually a lot more height to it. This is 2 foot by 3 foot by 2 foot. My Vietnamese Blue Beauties did need an upgrade, and this tank I felt would be really suitable for them. Due to her age, if you guys remember, she is almost 30 years old. So she's quite the old lady, and she doesn't have as much energy to her as she did when she was younger. Felt that the younger, more active snakes could use the bigger enclosure. She did lose a foot on the end, but she did gain another foot up top. So she has more climbing space up top now. And then you guys might have noticed that there's already some new inhabitants in the cat gecko. cleaned out and redid the enclosure a little bit so that it would be suitable for my long-tailed grass lizards. This is one of my females. I believe my other female's up there. One of them, I believe, is gravid again. I think it might be that one, but you can't see at this angle. Here's some of the long-tailed grass lizard babies that I'm breeding too. Look how cute they are. So tiny. Oh my god, I see two little faces poking out behind there. Hello. So yeah, these guys are occupying this space now. And then behind me, I now have my crested gecko in this spacious 18 by 18 by 24 vivarium. I also cleaned this out and redid it just a little bit for my crested gecko. Added some more like sturdy branches, and I would like to add just actually quite a few more, some empty spaces up in here that I'd like to fill in. But yeah, I'm really happy with how things are turning out right now. That's what I've been doing in here. I rearranged some of the animals. I've been doing some upgrades and moving things around and so on and so forth. So where on earth is Salem now? His habitat still resides on this rack, but it is just now on this shelf down here. So this is now Salem's new bioactive vivarium. I am so happy with how this turned out. I wish I filmed the progress of making all of this. I was able to get just a little bit of footage of me making this. You see, I actually was planning on doing a video on doing the DIY custom background for this habitat. And here I actually have some of the video footage of that, and you can see me making the tank here. And I remember being really excited finishing off the habitat and finishing off filming it. And then when I went to go edit the video, I couldn't find half of the video footage at all. It's like it just disappeared, or I had accidentally deleted it or something. And I was really sad about that. And I was like, no! I would have had a video out for you guys a lot sooner, but lost half of the video footage for that. So I am really, really disappointed. But you know what? It's not the biggest deal. There's gonna be lots of opportunities for me to film other tank backgrounds that I'm gonna wanna do, so I'm not super bummed out about it. But at least I can show you guys the final results of what I've done. So let's take a closer look at his new vivarium and see what I've done. So the part of the video footage that got deleted of me doing this DIY background was me siliconing it and like carving it and like sticking all the dirt on, and that's the part of the video that just for some reason got deleted. But I just stuck on some EcoWorth with some aquarium safe silicone, and for some final touches I added these fungi ledges. Look how cute they are. I stuck about three into the background, so I have one here, I have one mushroom ledge back here, I have one that I stuck in the back over here. This big one up here actually didn't stick into the background. I actually kind of just like balanced it on the cork bark that I had stuck in the background. And then we have some of these cork bark hides that I'm hoping my cat gecko will go into. So I have this one sticking out over here, and I shoved some sphagnum moss in that a little bit to make it comfortable if he does want to go in there. Same with back there, I shoved it with some sphagnum moss in case he wants to take a nap back there. And then I also put two flower pots in the background so I could put some spider plants coming out of the background over here. For some other hides, I just have some cork flats that I have kind of throughout the enclosure. So I have one back there that I've kind of like dug out a little bit so that he can hide under it. I have another cork flat right up here, and another way in the back over there. And he's got a little water bowl back there, but they mostly will drink the water droplets from the leaves. So instead of going out and buying all these expensive plants, I just kind of reused some plants that I already had that weren't doing so well and just put them all into this tank, and it looks like they're starting to come back to life. So it's looking good. Here I have a little snake plant that wasn't doing so well.
a monstera plant that also wasn't doing so well, a bella palm, another type of palm plant. I forget what this one's called though. Spider plants. These spider plants were actually like little baby spider plants that I had from the big one in my room. And some pothos trimmings just from some overgrown tanks. I also got this really nice Malaysian driftwood piece. I wish you could like see like how pretty it actually is. It's got just like all these like different branches and stuff coming out. So if he wanted to, he could like burrow under here and hide under there as well in the daytime. I thought that would look nice over there. And then I also just filled it in with a bunch of like really thin branches that he could climb on and explore. And for the isopods and springtails, I added some leaf litter in the back area and just kind of spread it all around to make it look as natural as possible. Even if you don't have isopods and springtails, it just helps the vivarium look like so much more natural and just like you have a piece of the rainforest in your home. For lighting, I actually have a 24-inch long 5.0 UVB RepTiSun. Now, the reason that I have UVB for my Malaysian cat gecko is actually because I am getting UVB for almost all of my reptiles, whether they are diurnal, crepuscular, or nocturnal. I've been doing some reading and a little bit of listening to some podcasts about how nocturnal animals and even snakes can benefit from UVB lighting. Recently, there was a video that came out from a YouTuber called Animals at Home, and the video is called Do All Reptiles Need Full Spectrum Light? And what it is, it's a podcast with Dr. Frances BAINES. She has decades of experience studying the lighting requirements for reptiles, and I actually highly recommend that you guys check out that podcast. I'm actually going to put it as a link in the description box, and I really, really encourage you guys to go check it out. And I've already started to see some of the benefits in the reptiles that I've been keeping. All right, so we've seen some of the upgrades. We've seen the new vivarium. Let's go take a look at how Salem's doing. I have absolutely no clue where he could possibly be. So here he finally is, Salem, my Malaysian cat gecko. Here I'm actually introducing him into the enclosure for the first time. He was a little overwhelmed at first, but then quickly began to explore and settled right in. I think he's going to really love this habitat, and I also look forward to hopefully adding another one in here in the future. He's been doing great, and I don't know what more to say.
Well, thank you guys so much for checking out this video, and I hope you liked the new vivarium that I have set up for Salem. I'm also really excited for some new upcoming videos that I swear are actually going to be coming out. Since a lot of my projects and things are almost done, I'll be able to have more time to finally film the final results of them and show you guys what I've been up to. Don't forget to check out my other social media, which you can find in all my links. You can find me on Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, and here. Stay weird, everyone, and I will see you all next time.